on Weather Underground. We are tracking dangerous severe storms in the east tonight. Today, we've got those thunderstorms across sections of the northeast. So again, giving you a virtual view of what you can expect around New York City. Thunderstorms will be the norm here as we go through the next few hours. And we're also, by the way, going to be watching for storms again tomorrow. So your future radar shows that story. We start things off about an hour from now, and we're going to be watching for those storms racing along the East Coast, also back into interior parts of, say, the Northeast and down the Appalachians into parts of eastern Tennessee, North Carolina, even North Georgia as we get into the late evening hours. During the overnight, portions of the I-81 corridor here in Virginia, Outer Banks, and coastal sections of North Carolina remain active. So don't be surprised if even overnight you're hearing some rumbles of thunder and hearing that rain really coming down with intensity. Tomorrow morning, starting off the morning commute with some showers and storms around some of the big cities as well, like New York City. So this virtual view, very applicable tomorrow to start the day. Philadelphia, we've got the thunderstorms out there through the next few hours. So I'd say 6 to 8 o'clock, your best chance time frame for some of the heavy rain, as well as those severe threats, the gusty damaging winds, and that potential for hail. We go into the overnight and staying pretty quiet around Philly, but as we get towards tomorrow morning, a few scattered thunderstorms and driving towards the drive time, could see a few showers out there. Washington, D.C., again, now through about 8 o'clock would be your main time frame to see some of the more powerful showers and thunderstorms. Again, wouldn't discount the severe warnings like what we've got right now around and outside of Baltimore. Tomorrow, very early, a few more passing showers. So that could have you using the windshield wiper for the morning commute. Mike?
All right.
Texas are going to continue to bring that threat for some flash flooding. Keep in mind, we've got already saturated ground. Now we're adding more rain into the mix. Atascosa, Karnes, and Wilson counties. These are areas to the south and east of San Antonio. We have flood advisories in effect here, and we can see more rain is coming down. So this isn't one of those situations where we're like, hey, the rain has come to an end, but the water is going to remain high. Water could get higher in some of these areas as the rain continues. And it's moderate to heavy rain in a lot of these locations. You can see all the lightning. So we've got thunderstorms dumping with it some torrential downpours. And there's more flood advisories scattered across the area. So this means those small creeks, those streams are going to be on the rise. And we could even see some problems with water over normally dry ground or road. Rainfall to come between now and Tuesday in the 3 to 5 inch range. So we're looking at some pretty hefty totals here. Again, this is coming over a stretch of 4 to 5 days. However, we've already got a lot of rain in some of these areas. And so you add more downpours, especially knowing that it's the possibility of heavy downpours, thunderstorms, which can leave a quick inch or two in a short period of time. That makes us go, flash flooding could be a real problem. So I want you to be aware of that, especially if you have any plans to be on the roads over the next few days. And I'm pretty sure that applies to just about everybody. Rainfall accumulation over the last 7 days. This is what we're talking about in terms of saturated ground already. We've got 3 to 5, 5 to 8 inch totals galore across central and southern Texas. So again, we've got that waterlogged sponge ground, and now we're adding more rain into the mix. So this is why we think flooding looks to be likely in some communities here moving forward. And it's all thanks to this upper disturbance. This triggers the wet weather, but it's not really moving very quickly. So it's going to stay over the same areas. We've got that deep tropical moisture headed in, and unfortunately that means days of rain chances, Mike.
All right, let's nail down.
It's also making roads slippery. This driver ran right off a rainy road last night in the Houston area and ran right into a rain-filled ditch. Now, he had to get towed out, and he's lucky it was not much worse than that. We've seen much scarier scenarios for people getting caught in vehicles in water. And sometimes you just can't avoid being out on the road in the pouring rain. We get it. Well, Weather Channel meteorologist Reynolds Wolf shows us why wet roads can be so tricky and how to stay in control. Break down where it is and where it's going through the weekend. Expect temperatures 10, 20, even 30 degrees above average across a lot of the northern part of the country. That includes parts of Intermountain West, Northern Plains, Great Lakes, Mid-Atlantic, northeast of New England. A lot of these spots in that well above average, even record-breaking territory. Tomorrow, the records possible across places like Bismarck and International Falls, Rapid City and Grand Forks. So we're talking the Dakotas and northern Minnesota. That's where temperatures are expected to rise into the 90s, even low triple digits. Grand Forks predicting a high of 101. Bismarck, North Dakota, 102. That would easily break your records. Both cities have records currently in the mid-90s. So I don't even think it's going to be close. We look at Minneapolis, where your average high is 75. We're 20-plus degrees above the mark Friday. Saturday, Sunday, low 90s. There's your break on Monday. Back to the mid-90s on Tuesday. And the coolest day of the next six, Mike, is Wednesday with a high of 90.
These numbers are
round, so we reduce those opportunities further. Well, if you feel hot while you're outside, chances are your dog does too. Here are some do's and don'ts to keep your four-legged family safe this summer. Watch and be aware of, especially if you live in these areas, you're going to be out on the roads. Everyone's like, yeah, I got to make it to school or work over the next few days. I guess maybe school's not in session anymore. Well, I don't know. Some schools go until June. Regardless, you've got to get to and from work. You might have weekend plans. You're going to be out on those roads, but we could be dealing with some flash flood warnings here in the days to come, as well as flood advisories and river flood problems, too. We've got 3 to 5 inches. That's what we're expecting from areas east of San Antonio, around Houston, even up to communities on the southeast side of Dallas. So that added to an already very saturated ground, not going to spell good news when it comes to waterways and, of course, the possibility that we get water into some areas that it should not be. Right now, we've got some heavy rain rolling slowly east of San Antonio, a lot of lightning as well. And you can see we've got flood advisories around the southeast side of San Antonio, also now piling up in and around the Houston area. So water problems already a result of some of these heavy rain showers, and all that yellow red on the map, all that's telling you is the rainfall rates are coming down at a heavy rate. So we're picking up a lot in a short period of time. And with these not moving quickly, that's even making those totals higher. Gonzales, Karnes, and Wilson County here under a flood advisory. So this includes the east side of San Antonio, a little bit of I-10, and then communities farther to the east. We've got Nixon as one of the communities in the path or in the inclusion of this. When we look at the radar estimated rain just over the last 6 hours, Mike, some of these spots approaching 6 inches of rain.
The numbers are
out walking around, right? One, comfortable shoes. Two, hydration. Three, dress for the weather. You're going to be walking around some of these cities over the next few days. We're going to be talking about near record heat. So if you're like me, you don't really deal well with the heat so well. Think about this. Take breaks. Have things to do maybe in the air conditioning between. This is not one of those times you go out and you do a 10-mile walk around the city throughout the day with no breaks. Potential record highs as we go through Monday. You can see the northern tier of the country, really from west to east. Also Miami. Miami's like, hey, don't forget about us down here. We tap the talk scorching car scale. Of course, one of the things that comes along with summer and all the fun and things that we do in the warm weather, also dangerous when we talk about vehicles. Vehicles where children are left in cars, pets are left in cars, or vehicles that are just left in the driveway that become a spot that the kids seek out, get themselves into it, and then can't get out. So remember to keep those cars locked when they're in the driveway. And if you are going anywhere, you're going to be going and leaving that car parked. You look before you lock. You leave the pets at home. Rapid City, South Dakota, a high tomorrow of 96, but after 10 minutes, 115 degrees within that car. In Bismarck, 102, the high 121 degrees within 10 minutes. So a lot of times we tend to think, oh, well, I'm just going in for a few minutes. The majority of the warming happens within the first few minutes. That's when things can get dangerous and deadly in those 5 to 10 minutes. Temperatures tomorrow, 10, 20, even 30 degrees above average, and that continues to expand through the weekend. So Friday, Saturday, Sunday will be warming days as we look towards some of our northeast cities. Tomorrow and Saturday, we're going to be looking at potential records across the northern tier. Minneapolis forecast high of 98 would easily beat the record of 92. Fargo, we think you're an easy set. set at 102. Aberdeen, you're going to be close, but I still think you're going to break it. 104, the forecast high. And in Bismarck, 99 on Saturday. Should easily beat that record of 96 degrees. Sunday, Newark, Syracuse, Binghamton, and Dulles, Virginia, all looking at potential records. Mike?